for me. Okay, so keep smiling. Oh, thank you so much. I really love you all. Okay, lots of messages I'm receiving right now. You are the best. You are this and that. Oh, thank you so much. And I always say it's a lovely question. How are you? And it's a very important question, which I really feel very beautiful question also. Yes, so I'm really very happy to see you all. I'm fit and fine, ready to go with my craft item. So as you all know, what we are going to do, making moving fish. Now, why we are calling it moving? Huh? So you don't have glue. Okay, no problem. I will solve all the problems. I have all the solutions. Yes, as you all know. Okay, so those who are old students, welcome again. And those who are new, welcome, welcome, welcome. And keep in touch. Okay, so let's start without wasting any time, because I'm receiving now there are some confusion with the material also. Okay, so let's start. So as we all know what we are going to make. So let's start. Just give me a second so that I can fix my phone and be ready with your material, and I will solve all the problems. And as ma'am already told you, you all are on mute. As you all can see, it's a big, large crop. Okay, so I will try my best to answer all the questions. So don't worry. Okay, let's start. Just give me a second so that I can fix my phone so that you can see everything clearly, which is very important. Mm-hmm. Till then, keep questioning so that I can answer your questions. Otherwise, I'm sure that I'm going to teach you in a way that there will be no problem. Okay, I will try my best, but if you have problem, I'm here. Okay, so here we go with very simple tools. Okay, these are called tools. So we are not mechanic, of course, but actually we are, because we are going to make a beautiful piece of art. Yes, so we always call these material as a tools. So these are very simple tools today we need. So first of all, you need colored sheet. Okay, I'm going to use yellow color. Please listen to me very careful. Drop everything and just listen to me, because I have taken so many classes now, and many of you are now used to for my classes. So please, I'm not going to repeat again and again and again 5, 3, 5, 6 times. Okay, please drop everything and listen to me very carefully. If you don't have colored sheet, that is perfectly fine. Whatever sheet you have, it is colored, choose your color. Okay, and if you don't have, use white sheet also. And those who are not having any kind of sheet, you can use newspaper or magazine sheet. If you have magazine, take one, pick one sheet from that and use that. Okay, I always say one thing, it is your learning time. So just learn, and after the class you can explore your skills. Okay, so let's start. So whatever sheet you have, you can use that. I am using right now A4 yellow sheet glue. So I'm using this glue. Whatever glue you have, stick glue or whatever glue you have, that is perfectly fine. Someone has written that I don't have glue. If you don't have glue, then you can use cello tape, or I think the best thing substitute will be a stapler. If you don't have a stapler, then use cello tape. What to do? Okay, so if you don't have glue, use stapler or cello tape. Okay, scissor, you need scissor for cutting work. Be very careful, telling you in advance. Pencil, scale, ruler. For ruler size, whatever size you have, that is perfect. Okay, so I'm using this size. Whatever size you have. I don't have pencil or black sketch pen. Whatever thing you have for drawing, okay, just use that. See, before I start, I really want to clear one thing. Whatever we are going to draw today, that is only for idea. So it means whenever we are going to do anything for idea, for making everything little simple, so we are going to use very light pencil, okay? Because we are after cutting, we are going to rub that. So you have to use very light pencil. So please don't use sketch pen or pen for drawing. Please use pencil, because I am also using, usually I always use sketch pen for drawing, but this time I'm using pencil, okay? Okay, let's start. I think I'm not receiving any question regarding material. So I think everything is clear to you all smart, smart children. So let's start. See, something is written that you have printed a sheet or what, then whatever side you want, we are making fish, okay? And we are dealing with beauty. Yes? So why I'm telling this, we are dealing with beauty because we are talking about nature, fish, animal, yes, aquatic animal. And we all know that fish having so many beautiful varieties, some are having beautiful color combination, some are having beautiful pattern on their bodies. So if those who are using pattern sheet, na, those who are using printed sheet, the sheet which are having the side, one side plain and one side printed, then use printed side as a upper side so that the fish will look more beautiful. Okay. Okay. I think no confusion now. Now let's start. Please take your sheet. Keep it in a landscape size. This is landscape. You can use, yes, you can use glue stick, as I always told. Already told you, you have to listen to me very carefully. Yes, whatever glue you have, you can use that. Okay. So this is called landscape. This is called portrait. When we keep our sheet like this, this is called portrait size. When we use like this, this is called landscape. Whatever sheet you have, dear, please use that. Whatever sheet, whatever color, if you don't have colored sheet, use white sheet, printed sheet, colored sheet, newspaper, magazine sheet, whatever sheet you have, use it. Okay, just try to learn. Okay, let's start. Now, take your this corner and we have to fold, but before folding, before giving a beautiful fold, you have to look here that it should be a very pointed one. Okay, we have to join this side to this side like this. First observe, then start. First observe, then start. It means you have to look first, observe first. When you understood everything clearly, then start. What I have told you, take your this corner. We have to join this side and this side together with a very sharp cone. Side like this. See the cone, beautiful cone, and the both the sides are equally like this. Yes. Then take your scissor. Those who are comfortable with cutting part, please do it with yourself. But very carefully, those who are not comfortable, please take help. Okay. Hold your sheet like this and we are going to cut this part. We are going to remove this extra part. Okay. With the help of this crease line. So I'm not going to draw it. I'm going to just taking help from the another fold. We have to remove this extra part. Please don't throw that. We are going to use this piece of paper also. So after every step, I'm going to give you a little time. Can you open the page? Yes, It is going to be a square, beautiful square, perfect square shape. This one. Yes. So see, we have learned how to make square shaped sheet. If we have this kind of sheet, A4 sheet or A3 sheet, and if you need square shaped sheet, then you can use this technique and make it in a square shape. Wonderful technique, don't you think? Okay, now I am receiving done ma'am, wonderful. Okay, so now let's start with next step. Please keep this paper carefully, we are going to use it. Okay, now after this, keep your sheet like this and open it. You are going to have this crease line on a center. You can see this crease line. Yes. Now what we need to do, we are going to hold this side and I'm going to fold it. I'm going to join this crease, this edge line to this crease line like this. First observe, then start. I'm repeating again and again this thing. And again, we need a cone over here, a sharp cone. First observe, then start. Very important. It will improve your observation power also. And for an artist, it's very important skill. See, what I have done, I have taken this side and I'm going to join this line and this edge line, crease line and edge line together. The sharp, this cone will be here and fold just like this. See, it is coming on this crease line. Yes, perfectly on this crease line. Fold. And then you have to do this side with the same technique. Fold it. Keep it on the center of that crease line. Manage that cone, the sharpness. And hold it properly and fold. Don't you think it's quite looking like kite? Yeah, it is. Nirma is playing like it is like a plane, huh? Nice observation. Yes. Okay, again, I can see many of you are done. Very good and very smart class, I must say. Okay, so now after this step, your sheet is going to be look like this. Now open your sheet. You are going to get, now this time you are going to get three crease lines. See these three. Yes. One, two, and three. Yes. Three crease line. So we are going to fold it with the first crease line. What I have done, I'm going to repeat it again. A sheet is going to be look like this after folding. Now I'm going to open it. Now we are going to get these three crease line, one, two, and three. Now I'm going to fold my sheet from the center crease line, the first one which we have made like this. See, again, we have that triangle shape, a pyramid shape, yes. Now you need your scale and your pencil. And again, I'm going to tell you one thing very important. Whatever we are going to do now, you have to use very light pencil. It's a request. Okay. If you really don't want to spoil your sheet or your work. Okay. Can you repeat? Yes, I can repeat myself. Please everyone look here, after all the folding, your sheet is going to be look like this, like a kite shape somehow. Now I'm going to open it. after opening your sheet is going to be look like this, three crease line. With the center crease line, I'm going to fold it like this. After folding with the center line, your sheet is going to be look like this. You can have this crease line. Okay. Now you need scale and your pencil. Now please observe first, then start. Please observe first. With this crease line which you are having, I am going to make one dot or one small line. It is about half inch from this corner. See, this is my crease line. I hope you all can see this crease line. I am going to keep my scale into it like this, and I am going to make mark. I'm going to mark, it is about half inch. See, it is about half inch. I have done it a little darker so that you all can see everything clearly. Okay. I have no option, but you have option. Please use your pencil very light. You can see half. Okay. This is about half inch. Now what we are going to do, crease line, half inch mark. Now I'm going to make linings, okay? Please look here first. Line from the crease line till the end of my sheet. From the crease line, from that point which we have made, okay, I have started. My first one is like this. Do not make like this. No, you have, your line should be straight. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to make lines, and I'm trying to maintain distance. You can increase or decrease the distance. That is perfectly fine. And I always say that this is your learning time. When you have learned this, all the steps, please try this again. And then you can try with not a straight line. You can use a wavy lines or zigzag lines also. That will also look beautiful. But let's start with a very simple one. Then it's totally up to you, your creativity. I hope these lines are visible to you all. I have again used very dark pencil so that you all can see everything clearly, but you have to use about lines. I did not count it, okay? Whatever space you have, according to your space, you have to make that line. I have already told you, I have tried to maintain distance between all the lines, but if you want to make, if you want more distance, make it more or less. What I have done after this, with this crease line, I have marked this dot. This dot, it is about, I have marked it about half inch over here, and I have started making these lines from this dot only. From this crease line till the end of my sheet. Okay. This dot is about half inch, and these lines I have done it freehand. So whatever distance you want, it's totally up to you. No measurement for these lines, the gap between lines, okay? Again, I'm receiving done. So as I already given you idea about these lines, that whenever you are going to do it again, this fish, after this class, you can accept these straight lines. You can use zigzag lines or wavy lines. Okay, it's totally up to you. Now, this point is going to be a face of mouth area of this fish. I really don't want this point one. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove this point. Okay, for that, I'm going to make this curve line. I really don't want this pointed mouth thing for my I really want a very beautiful fish, the adorable face. And now I'm going to cut this area so that we are going to have this curvy face, okay, a round shape face. What I have done, I have just removed this before after, simple one, okay. So before the pointed one and after. So if you want, it's optional. Those who want really a pointed one, that is perfectly fine. I don't want, it's my personal choice, so I'm cutting that part. If you want, you can also cut, or otherwise whatever you want. Okay, see, I can see everyone right now, but I cannot take everyone's name. It's quite impossible for me. It's a large group. So please try to understand. Okay. Okay, let's start with another step. What we are going to do. Now I'm going to cut these lines. I have already told you that whatever drawing we are going to do, this is for just for an idea. After cutting, we are going to rub that. So I hope you all have used very light pencil. Those who need help for cutting part, please take help. Perfectly fine. Those who are comfortable, start doing cutting, but be very careful. Very sharp cut you need. After cutting, see, these strips are going to be look like this. Okay, I hope after cutting your fish is also looking like this, the same. So see, those who have done any mistake, always remember, it's only a power, only art can give you that power actually. Which power? That you can fix your mistake. Okay? This is your learning time. Just try to learn, try to remember all these steps. Do it again after this class, and I'm sure you are going to, when you are going to do it twice or thrice, I'm sure that you are going to get a beautiful result. So don't panic. Okay? Calm. Be calm. Art is just for your, not for just enjoyment. It's really helping you with many more skills. It's really for your life, for your daily basis routine. Okay? So patience is the most important thing. Calm. Back part, if your back part will cut, no problem. It is going to be a tail. So maybe your fish is going to be have a different kind of tail. Be positive. Okay. After all, we are going to add tail also. So don't worry if your back part is, yeah, mistakenly cut it. Perfectly fine. No problem. In nature, you are going to have so many different kind of fishes. Yes. Okay. Let's start with another step now. I hope everyone done. Now open your sheet. Slowly, okay. After opening your sheet is going to look like this. Oh, looking lovely. Now we are going to paste. Okay, but what? Now we need glue. So be ready with your glue. Before pasting, I'm going to tell you how to paste. Then we are going to use this glue, okay? So first you have to learn. What I'm going to do, I'm going to paste this side and this side together, both the plane side together. How? See, because of crease line, because we have already folded both the sides, we have this beautiful crease line. So fold it again so that we are going to get a beautiful sharp fold now. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to touch, I'm going to keep this side with this crease, this sharp pointed one over here on this crease line. These edge line, I'm going to keep it over here like this. See, like this. And I'm going to fold this and see. Yes, yes. Perfect. I can see many of you are understood, but if someone having any issue, please look here. I'm going to do it again. What I have done, I have told you I'm going to paste this side and this side together. Okay. Now I'm going to use this edge line. I'm going to keep it over here on this crease line. Edge line, crease line, edge line, crease line, over here like this. See, then I've kept it. Okay, now I'm going to close this area very slowly and see. When we are going to paste it like this, your fish body is ready. And see why I'm telling you this is moving fish, because such a flexible body. Yes, okay. Many of you are done correctly. Wow. I think everyone, yes. So because of this, this fish name is moving fish. Huh? See? Great. Those who are using a little hard, not little hard, but yes, hard sheet, maybe there will be some difficulty for moving it, but no issue. Your look wise, it is going to be look perfect. Okay, so don't worry. Now let's start pasting. I hope everyone know. Now I'm going to apply glue over here on this, the side which we are going to keep over here. I'm going to apply glue like this and like this. I'm so sorry if you are getting some noises. It's a evening time, and so what to do, it is not on my control. Okay, so now again I'm going to keep it over here. What I have done, only do not apply glue over here, only on the edges. Okay, that is perfectly fine. Again, keep it over here. Close. Keep it on a base, a plain base, and keep your hand inside and just press it very slowly, slowly. And yes, of course, I think your hand is not going to become from this side. So you can use your scale and just press it a little bit so that it will fix perfectly. And see, very easy. It is moving. So your body, fish body, is ready. Ruby, I think Lakshit also doing wonderful job. Nirmai, very good. Okay. Shwetlana, wonderful job, dear. Dakshita Jain, very good. Mahi is also very busy right now. Nikunj, outstanding work, dear. Very nice. Shesha, wonderful. Okay, Nikki, very good. Bhavnika, very nice and beautiful name. Okay, let's start with another step. I think everyone done. It's quite difficult for me again to take everyone's name. Okay, see, both the are fixed now. Now take your leftover part, which we have cut it now in the first step. See, for this right now, I have already told you that fish having such a beautiful variety is. So for future, when you are going to make it again, you can use for tails and for wings and everything, you can use different kind of colors, colored sheet also for this step. But I really don't want to waste my page, so I'm going to do it with same color combination. I will also suggest that please do not waste your sheet. Use the same one, and maybe after this class, when you are going to explore your creativity, then you can use many different colors, okay? Okay, so now for this sheet, we are going to make tail and the wings, okay? So let's start. I'm going to randomly cut this much. No size, I'm just random cut. You can see this is almost my half hand, okay? Now fold it from the center. From the center. Now take your pencil, and I'm going to use my whole sheet. Please don't waste. Okay, so I'm going to use it every single side. And what I have done, I have made a petal type a curve line like this from the starting till the end with a little curve. Okay, it is looking, we can call it petal, or we can call it half leaf. It is looking like a half leaf also. And after this, it is not necessary to make the same thing. You want, if you want, you can make another sprawl tail also. And now cut. After cutting, because of fold, oh, beautiful heart shape I'm getting. Nice, na? So you will get similar, same or similar, or maybe a little different. So that is perfectly fine. So whatever you have cut, na, that is perfectly fine, because this is my fish. I'm Sushmita, and you are the individual personality. So you can. We cannot copy the exact the same anyone, because I have my own identity, you have your own identity. So that is perfectly fine. Okay, that is your style. So if you are not getting the same shape, perfectly fine. Use whatever you are getting. Okay. Now we are going to paste over here. See. Oh, lovely tail. Okay, so let's start pasting. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take my fish body, going to apply a little glue only on this corner. Not much, please remember this. Okay. Not much, a little. And going to keep it over here or on a center crease line. And I think it's done. See. Lovely. So see, okay, let's start with all the cutting and pasting part, then I will give you more ideas so that you can make your fish more, even more beautiful. Okay. Okay, let's start. I think pasting time. Let it paste. Okay. Just keep it little bit, press it and keep it like this only. When we are going to do the next part, let it dry. Okay. Now I'm going to use this sheet. Fold it. And now I'm going to give again petal shape like this. You can give petal shape or any other shape also, like this also. I mean the different shape. It's totally, I'm doing it a very simple one so that everyone can do, okay? And after this class, you can explore your creativity. And I really request you, I really want to see your creativity, this today's work. Cut, because of fold, we are going to get two shapes at the same time. Same size, see. We are going to paste it over here. Don't you think now it is looking complete, but still the eyes are missing, but don't worry. Step by step, we are going to do everything. So again, the same thing, but in a different style, because we have to paste it in the same side, same place. Okay. Both the sides should be same, exactly same. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to apply glue on these both wings at the edge side. A little bit glue is enough, just a two dot maybe, or a small line. I've applied glue both the sides, you can see. Okay, keep it, and slowly you have to keep it inside at the base. And if it is on the same place, use your hand and press it a little bit from the inside of that board mouth. Okay, if you want, you can paste it over here also, or here, what, wherever you want. I really want it over here. You can shift it a little bit downside also. And see, okay, both the sides. I'm going to paste it, press it a little bit, and your paper moving fish is almost ready. Now, let's start with making eyes, which are very simple. Those who are having those who are using very dark sheet. Dark sheet means dark blue or dark green. Maybe when you are going to use your sketch pen or black pen for your eyes, making your eyes, it is not that visible. Okay, so you can use white sheet, draw and cut and paste. And those who are using these kind of light sheet, white or pink or yellow, light colored sheet. Now take your fish, and we have to make one eye over here and one over here. This is going to be, this crease line is going to be your center side. We have to make it over here. Those who are having that artificial ready-made eyes, googly eyes, which we call, please use that if you have. Otherwise, you can draw. And those who don't want to draw directly, you can draw, cut, and paste also. And all the options are open. It's up to you now. Okay. Now, lovely moving fish. I hope this much is done now. Oh, great. I'm not receiving any query till now. It's a long time. Great, huh? I have given so many options for your eyes. So whatever suits you, use that option, okay? So we have this beautiful fish now. So now I'm going to share some beautiful ideas so that you can explore your creativity even much more. And I always suggest that whatever we are going to learn, whatever you are going to learn, any art piece, anything, dance, sports, or anything, every art needs a little practice. Okay, not little, but yes, practice. Okay, so please practice again, do it again so that you can learn all the steps clearly. And now I'm going to give you some ideas so that your fish can look more beautiful. See, it's a simple yellow or whatever color you have used. It's a simple fish. Now you can add colors over here, or maybe some few lines or glitters. You can use glitter. Okay, you can use these kind of lines. And over here also, see, okay, these lines. Or maybe if you have glitter pen or glitter normal, that powder one, use that to decorate it. You can paste any stone, or maybe you can make a design pattern from that glitter over here on these strips. Yes. Yes. And if you are going to do it again, and if you really want to make it more, even more, much more beautiful, before pasting this body, okay, this part, you can make a beautiful pattern all with all these strips, then paste it, and then your fish is going to be look beautiful. Okay, and I can give you one more idea how you can decorate it. So if you have thread, those who really want to do that, it's optional, it's totally optional. If you have thread, I hope everyone having thread, whatever kind of thread you have, just puncture this area, make a hole, tie a thread, and you can hang it like this. Okay, and if you have waste stick, the stem of any tree, okay, the waste one, so you can tie that thread and tie it at that on that stick and play with that. It is looking like that you have come from fishing, huh? So I hope you like it. Yes, 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 yes or no? Come on, show me thumbs up. Write it down on the chat box if you really like today's work. The paper moving. See, it's a beautiful, flexible one. Huh? I think she always do the yoga. Yes, the flexible body you can see. It was fun. Okay. Viraj, thank you so much. Even I also feel very happy to see the results. A beautiful result from everyone. So I really want to appreciate, and you can clap for yourself, Anna, and I'm clapping for you all, that you have done wonderful, wonderful, wonderful job. And I hope that I'm going to get even much more better and beautiful fishes from you, your side. Make many more with different size, not only this size. You can use different size with different color, okay, and hang it different areas. So I hope. Great. Okay.